In this video, I'd like to show you how to work with iPhone HDR footage in Final Cut Pro. With the Final Cut Pro 10.6.6 update, new HDR features were added, which changed the workflow. Let's take a look. If you've ever experienced extreme overexposure levels when previewing clips in the browser and viewer, you're likely dealing with clips captured with the HDR mode enabled. Since iPhone 12, the cameras have the ability to capture HDR as an HEVC video file. I've got some HDR footage captured with my iPhone 14 Pro Max. In Final Cut Pro, start by setting up a wide gamut HDR library. Choose New, Library, and set it to Wide Gamut HDR. Import your video. I'll import a mix of HDR and SDR clips. Scrubbing through the clips, you'll notice that everything appears correctly in the viewer. I'll create a new SDR project and drop a mix of HDR and SDR clips on it. HDR also appears correctly on the timeline. Final Cut Pro now has an automatic color conform setting in the video inspector that makes sure everything is displayed properly. And it's telling me it's doing an automatic conversion of HDR HLG to SDR. If I uncheck the box, you can see the blown out, unconformed look you would have experienced from previous versions of Final Cut Pro. Now let's work in an HDR timeline. Set your project settings to the appropriate color space. For iPhone HDR, you'll use Wide Gamut HDR Rec 2020 HLG. The color conform conversion also works if you have SDR footage or graphics created in SDR and you'd like to manually convert them to HDR to make them as bright as the footage on the timeline. Titles dragged to an HDR timeline will generally auto-conform. If not, you can use the manual color conform, or some titles might have HDR parameters, like a white level setting. Final Cut Pro defaults to automatic HDR color conform in Preferences, General, so check the box there if something is not looking right. Also new in Final Cut Pro is a Color Adjustments Correction Panel to help you easily balance any footage. It's in the Color Inspector's drop-down menu at the bottom. Simply choose the format of your HDR footage, in my case, HLG, and it will handle the math of color corrections to the footage. It will choose based on your project settings, so you'll need to manually change it if you have a different source of footage. A side note, to monitor HDR footage properly, you need a monitor that supports HDR. I'm looking at two monitors, my 2021 MacBook Pro, which has an XDR display, and an LG monitor, which is SDR. If you're using an SDR monitor, Final Cut Pro has an option to view HDR footage as tone mapped in the view menu of the viewer. Once your HDR timeline is edited, you can share on YouTube, which supports HDR or SDR playback depending on the viewing hardware. It will handle the conversion for you. Current consumer hardware includes Apple TV 4K, connected to supported TVs, MacBooks featuring XDR displays, and monitors with HDR support. And of course, the iPhone you shot your footage on. You can export a master file as ProRes 422 to have the full HDR information. Note the color space on the export dialog as Wide Gamut HDR Rec 2020 HLG. There's a new choice that will make a smaller file for sharing, HEVC High Efficiency Video. Make sure the codec is set to HEVC 10-bit HLG. This gives you the HDR color space and embeds the metadata so the playback device knows it's HDR. An iPhone capturing Dolby Vision HDR puts a lot of power into the hands of consumers and professionals alike. Create with a wide range of video effects at FxFactory.com.